English Reading Practice, Exercise 8, How to Get Ideas, Advanced Level. Be sure to watch the introductory video to this playlist before doing this exercise. Just click on the link below in the description. Here are the instructions. 1. Turn up the volume so the teacher's voice is loud. 2. Read the words in red out loud at the same time as the teacher. 3. Pay attention to the teacher's voice intonation and the word groups. And 4. If you find the speed is too fast, go to the playlist and choose the intermediate version. Before we start, a quick reminder, continually improve your English by subscribing to this channel. Just click the subscribe button, then the bell icon, and then all. Let's begin the reading. How to get ideas. It can be challenging to create new ideas. You can sit and ponder and meditate for hours without getting any inspiration or creative thought. Thankfully, there is an easier way. Borrow a technique or idea that has a proven track record from an unrelated industry and apply it to your task or problem. Let us consider a prime example, Henry Ford and the motor car. By the time Henry Ford started making automobiles, there were thousands of mechanics working in small workshops building motor cars. These mechanics needed a wide knowledge and expertise in how to use a vast variety of tools. In addition to needing highly skilled mechanics, building automobiles also required time, as it was a time-consuming process. What separated Henry Ford from all the other automakers? The assembly line method. Did Henry Ford invent the assembly line? No, he borrowed the idea from another industry, an unrelated industry. He focused his attention on butchers and meat packers in Chicago. He visited a meatpacking factory in Chicago and saw that each animal carcass moved along on an overhead rail. Each butcher remained in his assigned position, and as the carcass passed in front of him, he cut off an individual piece of meat. They stood in one place, holding one tool. The whole process was a demonstration of organization, continuous flow, and efficiency. Henry Ford immediately recognized an opportunity for his automobile business. He drew plans for a conveyor belt that carried car frames and parts from one mechanic to another. Each worker had his own spot and put a single piece on the frame, with only the tools needed for that specific operation. Soon, Henry Ford was overseeing mass production of the automobile, and other car makers soon adopted the same idea so that it became an industry standard. The basic principles that Ford employed were 1. The tools and workers should be placed in a sequence so that each component part should travel the least possible distance. 2. Have some kind of carrier to take the section to the next worker, so a workman simply drops his part in the same place each time, and the part is then carried to the next worker in the line. And 3. The parts to be assembled should be delivered at convenient distances to the workers who need that component. So, if you are stuck for ideas, gazing into the air, hoping inspiration will follow, why not try Henry Ford's method? Focus your attention on an unrelated industry that may face the same challenges you are struggling with. Examine their methods and techniques and borrow their ideas. Of course, we need to be realistic. This also requires effort, and ideas are not just going to drop in front of you with no effort. However, concentrated attention on the problem or subject of focus will eventually yield results. Very often, the greater the distance between the problem and the industry you are going to compare it with can produce some of the best breakthroughs. So look outside your field or area of expertise. You may be amazed at the results. That's the end of the reading. Repeat this exercise many times until you can synchronize your reading with the teacher. Practice other exercises in this playlist and see a major improvement in your English speaking fluency. Has this video helped you? Then like, share or comment now. And build a powerful English vocabulary with my free course on Udemy. Just go to goodenglish.online.